One.
And then if it's funny, you're playing it. There's something you can tell me about that one time.
Yeah,
a
little bit.
Quack, quack, quack.
Okay. Do it however you want.
Water game.
Specific reason why everybody's wearing hats but myself, and even Kelly, you just got back from the West Coast, I understand. What's going on out there? Is it, you know, a waste of energy or
no? It's great. Yeah, it's great.
It's very
it's good. A lot of band, a lot of clubs. A lot of broads, a lot of booze, a lot of drugs.
Well, we don't do any of that stuff on this show. You know, there's no drugs going on over here. I just want to make that perfectly clear. You know what I mean? Kelly, you want to talk about this group, Faster Pussycat? Is that the name of the group? But it'll catch you, you know. I'm sure, like the chips, you know, it will link right away.
My moves really try to write to that, you know.
Yeah.
That's good. It's a real bluesy rock. It's no violence or devil or anything. It's like sterling.
Good time.
Good time
rock.
Yeah, I like it, you know.
Yeah.
Different than, you know, the stuff I was doing before. This is the way it's changed.
Well, you know, I'm really glad that, you know, Mr. Kelly Nichols took the time out of his, you know, busy career to, like, stop in while he was in New York. I ran into him the other night at the Cat Club, and I said, you are coming on the air. And here he is. Next to
Chris, I'm the guitar player, and I think you guys need to drink more sake.
Hi, I'm Kelly Nichols, and I'm the bass player, and see you in Tokyo, motherfucker.
That's Japanese for nice person.
Hi, I'm Steve Riley, I'm the drummer. See you soon.
Okay, do you have any kind of interest in episodes during the tour?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Louis.
I was just thinking of your particular episode.
Which one?
The one in Phoenix, moving along.
I had a baby in Phoenix, Arizona. This young girl, I don't know how young, pretty young, had to let me know that...
This is the picture of the baby.
Yeah.
This is the baby.
2.5 months old, Jeremy Roth.
Jeremy.
Yeah, it kind of freaked me out. I just found out a week ago. I'm a father.
It's really like on the road. We have a guy in charge of this, and it's like, what a job.
I know, and he plays bass guitar as well, so considering he does the two.
Smell my socks.
Welcome to the Rock Underground, the subway of rock and roll. Hang in, this is not a comedy hour. I have a great bunch of guys all the way from the Western Shores.
Where are you guys from? Where are you
from? Well, they're from the beach. I have the LA Guns right here in the studio in New York City. With me is Kelly Nichols, the bassist, and Steve Riley, the heavy-duty drummer. Welcome, fellas. How you doing, fellas? If anybody's seen in the limelight, Okay, I'm gonna ask you something stupid. I hope you're getting paid for this.
Nah, they're getting paid.
Go on. Polygram American. Okay, listen, I like to bring up a fan letter that, you know, everybody knows that, you know, Kelly's local, and everybody sees this guy in and out of New York. A fan letter that,
dirty.
I don't know what it is, but Dear L.A. Guns, okay, it's just signed Curious Fan, you know? You don't have to answer these questions, but, I don't know, let's see. We'd like to know from you guys, what is your favorite color?
Black.
Black, without saying, right? What signs are you?
Neon.
Is that your real hair or extension? Real. Definitely real. Okay, we got the other two answers. Do you like girls? Do you like girls who kiss on the first date?
I like girls that stink on the first date.
And, what are your shoe size? Okay, side carrier stand. That's the LA Guns. And when they're in your neighborhood, run. Pay somebody off.
Let's go over to Kelly, because he can't get up.
Oh, that's right. Poor Kelly. Kelly, we need to get you, Kelly.
Yeah, baby.
What happened here? I tripped on some wires back there in the back. I tripped on some wires. So.
No.
So
this looks to
Larry H. Parker.
I like 7 years. I like the toenails. I like the black look. It's there. Well, this looks like a motorcycle accident.
Yeah, it was a good one, man.
Was it really?
It was a real cool one. Really good.
What happened?
Look, they even love it when you get in motorcycle accidents. This is amazing. So. You got the black cast and everything. When are you going to be out of it? Another 12 years, I think.
It feels like forever. Does it itch like in there?
Yeah, bad.
Mm.
Yeah.
I was just asking, Phil, where do you get your clothes, though? You've got laced-up leather pants. We've got the killer boots.
Oh, Giorgio Armani says thrift stores.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, You're on the road a lot, so, I mean, you had to fly in from Buffalo just to do this gig.
Yeah.
And you'll be out again.
Yeah, we're in and out.
In and out.
With the number of beautiful women you hang out with and everything, have you called one your own yet?
Several.
You bad thing, you. I'm telling you, though.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about girls on the road. Come on, you've been strapping a few on. I've been reading all the rock and roll magazines.
They're strapping them on, man.
There's no girls on the road. What are you
talking about? You've got a tour bus, or do you just go and fly?
A couple buses, we fly here and there, and you know, it's basic rock and roll. You know,
vans,
it doesn't
all
change.
Kinds of things.
It just gets better.
Winnebagos.
What's the wildest thing that ever happened to you on the road?
This girl had three. No, I can't say.
So three right. Antlers.
Oh, the three antlers.
Yeah, everything. Well, everything that you would think could happen has happened pretty much. You know, but new things keep coming up that just blow your mind.
Do they really come up on stage and throw panties and stuff like that? Or is that just,
no, that's. You know,
they
throw all kinds of stuff. Yeah,
you
put them on the windshield wiper on the bus. At the end of the tour, it's like strewn.
What is the perfect girl like for you guys? I mean, if you had to choose.
Easy.
On that note, you can do the Ballad of Jane when you come back, right?
That's right.
Super. LA Guns will be back, and so are we. End of the night. The Great Houndini's coming up. Stay here.
It's very difficult because there was girls with breasts like this. And Phil had to do a scene with this girl in the back of the car, and he did it like 30 times. Just so he could hang out with her like every time. I was a stunt man.
Kelly Nichols gave me a black eye in San Francisco. So if you girls want to get a lynch party together, who's that else you're after?
You've been to Japan, Mark.
Yes, two times.
Just tour. Now while Saki says,
from now on the future plan for
I know who this is. Hello, who have we got here? Who's this?
This is Alf that a fan gave me, and if you like punch him in the...
Kitty.
So that was pretty cool that the fan gave me that, because I had Alf on the bike and Electric Gypsy, and I got tons of Alf junk like all over the place, man. Like you know, I need like 100 Alf puppets, you know? But it's cool, thanks.
Keep the Alfs coming. It took some time, I know what you're about. Oh, look what I found. Now I've got a series of
When I first joined the group, we were playing down on the strip, and we used to make these fires, these killer fires, and this was like a very sort of sentimental time for me. I was having like the best time of my life. This is when I was like the kid in the toy shop, and I think this was the very first photo shoot we did, and this was our old drummer Nicky Alexander, who's in the Cramps now, and he's great. And
he's a bad poker player, so he has to leave the band.
And this was the Saturday, June 20th, down at the Scream, and that would have been June, 87 or so, yeah.
This is a tobacco smoking pipe that I got in Nebraska, and this is a coyote skull. Let's see that? That's a coyote skull, and this is a deer antler that the smoke goes through the skull, and this is an oak stem here, wood, and never actually used it.
I see we've got a riding crop here.
Ouch.
And the thing about this riding crop, it makes me think of my horse, Star. Now, I've got this horse, it's kind of old, it's like 18 years old, but it's very big, it's like 17 hands, and it's got one eye. And it's a very kind, like fast, it was a horse that they used to, it was a cattle horse, it knows how to...
cook a good steak.
But the thing about this horse is it's only got one eye, so I have to watch going around corners because it can be a bit dodgy.
This was a Slurpee cup that I got in 1977 that. They sold it like 7-Elevens, which is a Kiss cup. They had the whole set, and I only got
is
this
that
one
G?
Left. Yeah.
AG.
And I had a little story behind them, and these only came out for one day because Kiss never approved of these coming out. So I went like there, like, you know, I was like hanging out, you know, like 2 in the morning, got one, and then I went back the next morning to get the rest, and they were pulled. So I've managed to keep this one since 1977.
This is how my debut price. To the music scene, and this came out in 1980. This funny thing about this record is you can either pick it up in like the humor section for like 2 or 3 cents, 30 cents or so, or I've actually seen them down at some of the sort of swankier record collection shops for 35, 40 bucks. Holy bollocks.
Holy bollocks. You know you're bullshit. He knows he's lying.
Yeah, this is it, and this was our second album. But
dude, you couldn't get a Coca-Cola for where those things are worth.
And didn't quite have the same thing, but I liked it. I liked it a lot, and this of course is our first record, and we all know about that. You know, back in these days here, we were free. We could do whatever we want, and as soon as we got to this stage, all of a sudden we started to get weird kind of creative restrictions, I guess we obviously learned how to deal with it because we're still here. So, thanks for watching, and thanks for having us back, and we'll see you very soon.
Yeah. Hey, you guys got a new video out, which I'm sure you'll want to tell us all about it.
It's called Electric Gypsy, and we shot it out in the desert in California, and it's pretty much all on motorcycles, not too much performance in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just been out for a couple of weeks now.
Now, what kind of motorcycles are these?
All Harleys.
Uh-huh.
All Harleys.
You wouldn't go for anything else besides Harleys?
It's questionable.
Well, we would, but, you know.
No, we were a Harley band. Okay? Yeah.
Now, you've had, was it two other videos so far?
Sex Action and One More Reason.
What are the main differences, do you think, between what we're about to see in the previous two?
Nudity, violence. the first one was really... We basically just did it for ourselves. It was like naked girls that kill us, and it was just supposed to be like fun, and it was.
Uh-huh.
It was fun. I get my head blown off, and falls off a building, but nobody would play it, so we have it. My mom likes it, so but these the last two are a little bit like tamer, so you know, so somebody can see them.
Well, you're gonna stay with us for well, for at least for this hour, right?
I'm hanging, babe.
Okay, let's take a look at Electric Gypsy. Here's L.A. Guns. All right, Headbangers, Adam Curry here with Steve and Kelly of L.A. Guns, drummer and bass player.
Finally.
Yeah, we figured that one out.
Those guys don't know.
Don't tell them about that. Now, of course, you know, all metal is best to be seen live. And you've been on the road with... oh, come on, don't give me that. You've been on the road with some veteran bands.
AC/DC, and we did some dates with Iron Maiden.
Mm-hmm.
And Ted Nugent, and we're going out with Cheap Trick and Def Leppard.
And is there a lot to learn for a relatively young band when you're on the road with guys like this?
Yeah, well, you know,
you learn how to drink heavy. They're pros, so they know what they're doing. But we're willing to learn, so.
How about musically?
Nah.
No?
No, yeah, there's plenty to learn. I mean, they're so professional and everything, and
mm-hmm.
you know, their shows run like clockwork, so, you know, we learn a lot. The whole crew learns, everybody learns.
Are there things that that you still want to perfect for your live shows?
Absolutely, yeah. You know, we're playing all the time. That's the best thing for us right now. That's where we're getting where we want to get. But that's the only thing that we could recommend is just keep playing all the time, you know?
So you said you're going out with Cheap Trick and...
Def Leppard. And then we're going to, like, wrap up this year with Japan.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll be 11 months on the road.
Really?
Yeah.
That's long enough for you?
I'm tired.
First of all, I want to thank you. I neglected to say that I was given this nice little present here. What is this officially called now?
The L.A. Guns Jewelry. I don't know.
Do you guys have these things specially made?
Our manager did. He had some of those just for promo.
Uh-huh.
He has clothing stores in L.A. on Melrose.
Uh-huh.
And all our money came from selling leather jackets and jewelry.
Oh, really?
To back the band.
But do you guys have other stuff that you make up as well?
Tons.
Or? Oh yeah, right.
Tons of stuff. Bring that truck.
Now, of course, there's you guys must get hassled all the time about, you know, questions about Guns N' Roses, and was it recently that there was some falling out between L.A. Guns and Guns N' Roses? I mean, I figured now you're here.
They did when they couldn't do the Iron Maiden tours anymore. They called us, and we were in Florida, and they asked us if we wanted to do it. So we said yes. So we flew the next day, right out to L.A. and started at Irvine Meadows, and we had all rented equipment because our stuff was being driven from Florida. So Slash and Izzy came out and played with us, and you know, it was just all rented equipment, and it just really sounded bad. So it's like, you know, they think we were like
the whole backline went down.
You know,
you know, we lost power on stage, and
we weren't sabotaging them or anything. It's like, you know, it's,
so there's no bad blood. It was just
absolutely not.
Right. We all sounded like crap, you know. So it was crap cut.
So nothing was lost.
No.
Right.
No, we don't think like that. I mean, we don't work like that. You know, we just wanted to play. It was great. Like,
you stay around. We got some cool videos coming up for you.
Okay.
And, I'm going to the bar around the block, and I'll be back.
Okay. Well, I'll see you in a minute then. Right now, here's Guns N' Roses, Sweet Child of Mine.
No, it's not that much difference, really. It's like the same sort of thing, clubs and,
legal.
And arenas and stadiums and stuff.
So you guys are working on your second album. When are we going to hear the second L.A. Guns album?
It's supposed to be July, and then it got put back to August.
So August.
Yeah. 91.
August 91.
Do you have any ideas what the titles are going to be?
Yes, we do.
It's going to be called Ricky Rockman.
Yeah.
I like that one.
Strikes Again.
Ricky.
Should we tell him?
Tell us.
It's called Cocked and Loaded.
Cocked and Loaded. That's good. We'll be back with more juicy gossip.
At the Omnium with members of
L.A. Guns.
L.A. Guns, thank you.
All right.
Okay, I'm here with...
Tracy Guns. Phil Guns.
Kelly Guns.
How do you feel about what's going on in Eastern Europe right now?
I don't know what's going on in Eastern Europe.
Well, they broke the wall down, which is great. It's something we never thought would happen in our lifetime. But of course, it all started with Motley Crue.
What got you interested in the music business?
Girls.
How do you guys feel about people throwing stuff?
I'll see you guys later, man.
Okay. We just lost one.